Are you struggling with insomnia? Chill out. I mean, you gotta lower the temperature in your room. If it's too hot or stuffy in there, air out the bedroom or lower the heater. Try falling asleep without a cover or just tuck a foot from underneath it. This trick works too. A warm shower before you go to bed can help a lot. First, the temperature of your body increases and then it decreases instantly. This contrast makes many people feel sleepy. A shower shouldn't be too long, about 3 minutes are enough. You won't get any cleaner after a half an hour under a cascade of steaming water, but you might poach. There's a relaxing technique that helps shake off all that tension you've had throughout the day. Relax all your body. First, focus on your face. Tighten all the muscles by squeezing them, including your lips and tongue. Then do the same with your neck, arms, and all the other body parts. Make your way down the body. The hardest part is about your thoughts. Try to make your brain think you're here to relax. To do that, think of any calming scene and visualize it. And yeah, it's okay if your mind wanders. Just try to go back to that soothing scene and focus on it. It might take some practice, but once you've mastered it, falling asleep will be easy peasy. You can also try another technique. Just repeat "don't think" over and over again. Sooner or later, your brain won't have any other choice but to give in and stop thinking. Don't worry, the effect is temporary, I think. There's a breathing technique that forces the mind and body to focus on regulating breath rather than thinking. First off, rest the tip of the tongue against the roof of your mouth. Let your lips part slightly and exhale completely through your mouth. Close your lips and inhale slowly through your nose while counting to 4 in your head. Then hold your breath for 7 seconds and exhale with a whooshing sound counting to 8. Repeat until you feel relaxed, but you'll probably stop it without a prompt at some point just because you fell asleep. Food is key to literally everything. A study shows that eating carbs a couple of hours before you go to bed helps fall asleep faster. Spicy food is a no-go for dinner, so opt for it to keep you up all night the evening before you go to a party. By the way, onions make me sleepy a lot. They contain one amino acid that acts as a sedative. Food eaten at night is most likely to be stored as fat. First, try not to eat anything at least an hour before you go to bed. 2, if you just can't help it, then try eating Brinner. The idea is to replace your dinner with a regular breakfast. Cheese, eggs, and all other things we usually eat for breakfast are rich in protein, which will help your muscles repair and grow overnight. Yeah! Time to bust another myth. Decaf coffee does have caffeine. A middle-sized decaf drink has about 7 milligrams of caffeine, while regular coffee has about 70. Yeah, 10 times less, but it's enough to disrupt your sleep. As for classic coffee, remember that coffee has a 6-hour half-life, so it takes about 12 hours to fully eliminate it from your body. There's no good morning without a good night, so if you crave sweets and junk food before you go to bed, there's nothing weird about it. Ooh, thank goodness. Chocolate and other sugary snacks soothe and calm you down, and your body knows it. If you're calm, you fall asleep in no time. But stay away from chocolate. It has small amounts of caffeine too. Just like with decaf, even a couple of milligrams might be enough to disturb your sleep. Ah, coffee is a no-go both before you go to sleep and right after you wake up. Cortisol, the stress hormone, is not only responsible for stress, but for sleep cycles too. It spikes between 8 a.m. and 9 a.m., so a cup of coffee only adds anxiety in the morning. Grab it when the cortisol is at its lowest. It also spikes between noon and 1 p.m. and between 5:30 and 6:30 p.m. No coffee at this time. Healthy foods rich in fiber are a bad late-night option. Those like broccoli are hard to digest, so leave them for lunch. This way your body has enough time to make the most of it. Overly citrusy food can make you feel uncomfortable too. Time for advice nobody really wanted to have. Turn off all your devices while you're sleeping and try not to browse social media before you go to bed. Technologies keep you up. Some researchers prove that video games before bedtime caused delayed sleep, watching TV led to early rising, and music provoked nightmares. You can prolong your night's sleep by reducing the nighttime phone use. Blue light all devices emit restricts melatonin production, and this hormone is the one responsible for the, you guessed it, quality of your sleep. Heavy blinds are a must for any bedroom. You can make the room dimmer, turning off all the lights inside, like phones, TV, and whatever, but don't forget about the street lights. A study showed that a too light room at night might be the reason why people gain too much weight. The same study said that people who slept in darker rooms had thinner waists. No workout needed. In the morning, open blinds are crucial. The rule is, the first thing you do in the morning isn't your bed. First, you gotta open the blinds. It'll give you extra energy even if the skies are gray outside. Don't rush to make the bed. To make sure you won't have any dust mites, let the linen air a bit. When you cover them up, there's no sun, a perfect environment for these insects. If you're still awake in the middle of the night with your eyes wide open, ask yourself a question. Am I really tired? If you're not, reconsider the next day plans and include a workout. You might need a half an hour of exercises to get somewhat more tired by the evening to fall asleep easier. Even a 10-minute brisk walk before bed will help. Never remember your dreams? Lucid dreaming is an actual skill you can improve through practice. A dream journal can be of great help. Right after you wake up, write everything you can remember immediately. We tend to forget most of our dreams in a couple of minutes after we wake up. Also, try repeating this mantra before you go to bed. Tonight, I'm gonna lucid dream. This way, you convey it to your subconscious and it might work. Then set an alarm for 2 hours before you normally wake up. Stay awake for about 20 minutes and go back to bed. This way, you enter a REM rapid eye movement sleep, which leads to consciousness in dreams. It's the deepest sleep phase, but your brain is now almost as active as when you're awake. Many studies show that we usually see dreams during the REM phase. Your good night's sleep starts during the day. Unlike the popular opinion, day naps can actually refresh you without disrupting your night's sleep. The key thing is to keep them between 15 and 30 minutes. It's enough to decrease sleepiness. Sheets made of synthetic fibers accumulate way more bacteria than those made of cotton. Plus, those made of natural fibers feel so much better to the skin. Pillows and pillowcases are important too. Make sure yours are not too high or too low, and it should be made of cotton too. If it's made of silk, even better. The skin will have less wrinkles because it will literally glide on the pillow. The hair won't get tangled since it won't rub up against the pillowcase. And the silkworms who make this stuff will appreciate the employment and your support. Lavender essential oil is a natural remedy for bad sleep. There are several ways to use it. You can diffuse it in your room half an hour before you go to bed, rub a few drops directly in the pillow, or apply it right to your feet and wrists. But make sure you aren't allergic to it. You might think your cuddly pet is a perfect companion in bed, but sometimes it's just not true. You don't notice how you accidentally push and toss each other, and it negatively affects the quality of sleep. Plus, all those hairs left in your bed aren't good for your skin. You might be allergic. Okay, I have no moral right to give this piece of advice. My cat almost evicted me from my own bed.